Hey everyone, welcome to the Basics lecture on Biotechnology. In this Basics video, you'll learn a bit about five technologies that are part of cell biology research. While you study, think about the biology that makes each technique work. First, let's discuss PCR. The purpose of PCR is to take a small amount of DNA and amplify it into thousands or millions of additional copies of that DNA strand. This is critical for conducting genetic research. The technique was developed in 1983. It's an experimental tool that makes genetic analysis of small samples possible. The process requires the original DNA, short primer strands, and individual free nucleotides. A DNA polymerase will build the new strands. The process works because when DNA is heated, the two strands separate from each other in a process called denaturation. Once strands are separated, primers match up with the ends, and new nucleotides are built using DNA polymerase. After one cycle, the original DNA strand has become two strands. Because the number of strands doubles with every cycle, the amount of DNA quickly increases. Our second technique is gel electrophoresis. Its purpose is to separate molecules based on size and charge. It was developed in the 1930s. It can separate DNA, RNA, or proteins. Sample results are generally the molecules separated in the gel. The molecules are often stained with a dye so they can be photographed or x-rayed. Gel electrophoresis uses a jello-like gel with a power source attached. DNA fragments are added to separate wells at one end, and an electric current is sent through the gel. DNA has negatively charged phosphate groups, and so the DNA moves towards the positive electrode. Smaller fragments move farther through the gel than larger fragments do. The results can be used to compare the amounts or sizes of molecules in question. In this gel, for instance, this lane is a reference lane with molecules of known size. This individual has all normal mitochondrial DNA, while her son has a large amount of mutant DNA of smaller size. Molecular cloning does not refer to creating a whole new organism, but to the process of creating a desired gene product. The procedure adds a foreign DNA sequence to the genome of the host organism, which is usually E. coli bacteria. The purpose is to make large quantities of the new gene and gene product for research or clinical use. Molecular cloning was first used in 1972. It creates colonies of E. coli bacteria that will indefinitely reproduce with the gene of interest within it. The first step is preparing both the foreign DNA and the bacterial DNA to stick together. A plasmid is a ring of DNA that E. coli bacteria are willing to take up from the environment. A biotechnology plasmid has several standard components. A DNA sequence called a restriction site that sits in the middle of a gene called LacZ and an ampicillin resistance gene. Both types of DNA shown here are mixed with a restriction enzyme that cuts DNA strands at the same base pair sequence. Notice the same base pairs are present in the sticky ends of both types of DNA. When the foreign DNA and the plasmid fragments are mixed together, the foreign DNA often attaches to the plasmid DNA. A ligase enzyme then seals the backbones back together. The process of adding DNA to the plasmid is random, so some plasmids reseal without the new DNA, as shown in this plasmid. And when the plasmids are mixed with bacteria, not every bacterium gets a plasmid, as shown here. Two steps are taken to make sure only bacteria with the plasmid with the new DNA are kept. The bacteria are grown in a medium with both ampicillin and a molecule called X-Gal that turns blue when metabolized by the enzyme LacZ. Only bacteria with the plasmid have a gene for ampicillin resistance and can survive in the new medium. Only plasmids that took up the foreign DNA have a disrupted LacZ gene. This means they cannot metabolize X-Gal and remain white. Researchers know that surviving white colonies, because they're alive and because they're white, contain the foreign DNA. cDNA stands for complementary DNA, a product often used in molecular cloning. As you know, eukaryotic genes contain a large number of introns that are not translated. Bacteria cannot remove introns, so a cleaned-up version of the gene is needed for the plasmid. The purpose of cDNA is to make a gene that contains only exons. The process of making cDNA was possible after the discovery of reverse transcriptase enzyme in 1970. To make cDNA, the mature mRNA of the cell is isolated from the cytoplasm and mixed with a primer and reverse transcriptase and free nucleotides. These build a DNA strand to match the mRNA in its complement. Normal eukaryotic DNA polymerase is then used to make the matching complement DNA strand, completing the complementary DNA. Lastly, let's discuss genetic sequencing. Its purpose is to determine the exact sequence of nucleotide bases in a segment of DNA. The method we'll discuss was developed in 1977 by Frederick Sanger. It produced a number of DNA molecules of different lengths, which could be separated in a gel and read. The ingredients are these: the strand with the unknown base pair sequence, primer and DNA polymerase, a large selection of regular deoxyribonucleotides, or loose nucleotides that can be used in replication, and a group of special nucleotides that have two particular characteristics. First, they contain a tag that gets in the way of replication and stops it. And second, this tag is a label that glows when light is placed on it. And it glows with four different colors depending on which nucleotide it is. Sequencing begins by placing multiple copies of the template and primer in a solution with both unlabeled and labeled nucleotides. The DNA polymerase begins to add nucleotides here at the end of the primer. For instance, the next nucleotide needed is a cytosine. If a non-labeled cytosine is added, then the polymerase continues and adds a guanine. But if a labeled cytosine is added, the label prevents the reaction from continuing. Every copy of a new strand is then stopped at a different height at the point which it grabs a labeled nucleotide. Some are stopped at the cysteine, some at the guanine, some at the first adenine. All of these separate strands are present at different lengths in the solution. The solution is then run through an electrophoresis gel, and a laser is passed over a gel, and the computer records the color bands that appear. The shortest strands move the farthest down the gel, so the cysteine band is the lowest, then guanine, and so on. The band of colors matches the order of nucleotides in the original DNA strand. Sanger sequencing has been replaced by next-gen sequencing techniques that use somewhat similar methods to sense each nucleotide, but it is exponentially faster and can run many strands at the same time. You can search for next-gen sequencing online to learn more. The field is changing so rapidly, the latest editions of your textbook cannot keep up with the technology. This completes our basics video for today. Be able to do the following for the basics quiz. Thanks for watching.